Sorry, I'm reviewing my trades for each day in the week and documenting my journey. So, as you guys can see, this week went very well for me. Not as good as I wanted it to be. I started out very slow with a profit of $71 on Monday, $172 and 22 cents on Tuesday, $231 on Wednesday, Thursday $270, Friday $235. So guys, Friday is the day I'm going to break down the trades for Friday. Guys, Friday was a little rough for me. I end up breaking my trading plan. I normally take 1 to 2 trades a day, guys, and I end up taking about 7 trades on Friday. But it's a blessing that I came out profitable on Friday, because I totally broke my trading plan. I could have blown my account on Friday, guys. I could have completely blown my account on Friday with some mistakes and over trading. So guys, as you know, we come in at 7 o'clock in the morning. We look for the highs that have been formed after 7 o'clock, the highs and lows. Here we had a highs, but we are basically looking for the equal highs and the equal lows. So guys, the market came, made this high right there, and then pushed down and continued making lows. That wasn't, you call that low resistance liquidity. So these lows was not taken, so I will dub these relatively equal lows. So as the market moved away to go for this high here, up to this high, I was looking for market structure shift. So we came down, there was this equal lows here, relatively equal lows. Price came down, took these lows and displaced up. So anytime price come down, take a low and displace up to the direction of the liquidity, leaving behind a breaker or fair value gap, this is my entry signal. So price did that right there, closing above this high. I put on 10 contracts and I ride it up to this high. Guys, I didn't take any partial here. So yes, I took, did I take a partial there? No, I didn't think I took a partial here. The price, I end up putting my stop to break even, and then price came back and took me out at break even. As I can see, I put 10 here and then minus 10 came out here. So I was break even on the first trade. Guys, the second trade, I was break even also, because after price took this high, we had a market structure shift here with a fair value gap breaker. I took a shot here, 10 contracts. Price ended up going in my favor, move my stop to break even. I was targeting these lows. I end up coming out break even. After price took these lows, guys, I had a displacement with a breaker, fair value gap. Yeah, here was a fair value gap, but I took it on the breaker, come back here on this breaker, took 10 contracts here. Price went in my favor. When I saw that price reversed on me for the two times here, and I came out break even. When it took the high, I took partials. I took eight contracts here. Yes, I took 8 contracts here and I left 2. But when price displaced through this high, leaving a fair value gap, I put on the next 10 contract here. The price was stalling here and I got scared and took off 8 here. Price went in my favor, and then reversed here. as I move up my stop, taking out the next four contracts. So guys, from there I was in profit, but there is where I started over trading also. So nice, I saw price come take out these lows, push up. I sold. Guys, when I sold here, price started moving my favor. When it came down here, I took off 8, but instead of I bought back 8, I ended up selling 8 again. So I had about, I ended up selling 8 or 10. I ended up selling 10 again. So I had 20 contracts, guys. And then that was it. So I had 20 contracts on the board, and then I started going into drawdown. So from there, guys, I don't know if I was down or if I was up. From there, I just did nonsense. I sold the hair again, price went in my favor a little, come back, took my stock. So there, I think there I was about minus 500 and something dollars here. So at that point in the day, that was about 9.57. But there was news, guys. Price went up into this Fair Valley gap that I had there on the 1 hour, and then it made some highs. I went on the 15 second, I took a trade on the 15 second, which put me back into profit, guys. Price was moving very fast and volatile. I think that was my biggest trade so far, but it was due to overtrading, guys. But luckily for me, I came out on the better side. I came out profitable. So guys, that was a trade I took. I ended up going to the 15 minute when price came into this 1 hour Fair Valley gap, and I think there was a breaker somewhere around there as well. Nice surprise push up, and then had a market structure shift right here on the 15 second with displacement. Price came up back into this Fair Valley gap. I sold 10 and I rolled it down here. I took off 8 contracts here, and then price reversed on me and took out the next contract. At this point, guys, I was, I think, minus 500, and then I think that trade net me about 800 dollars. Yes, that trade net me about 800 and something, so put me in a profit of 230 something dollars. But guys, I was so scared and I was over traded so much, guys, that I missed the trade for the day, for the morning. I missed it, the big trade that kept on running and running, guys. This would have surely given me a huge profit, guys. And I was waiting on that trade all morning, guys. Price came up, took this relative equal highs, broke down with a market structure shift right here, Fair Valley gap. I would have sold right here, and I would have rode that down right here to this equal highs, guys. So guys, over trading made me miss huge profit, made me lost profit. Guys, I just broke my trading plan. Friday was not a day I was proud of at all. Friday just wasn't a day I was proud of. Although I came up profitable on that day, it's still not a day that I was proud of, because I broke my trading plan by over trading, and that just messed with my head and kept me making mistakes, kept me pushing the buttons. So guys, that's it for the trade breakdown for Friday. If you like this content, be sure to follow me, subscribe, like, drop a comment, give me tips, give me ideas on ways to pass this challenge, give me ideas on ways I can get profitable, give me things, and drop some knowledge in the comment section. Guys, I'm really looking forward to hearing from you guys and seeing you guys comment in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Peace out.